this film kind of follows the nightmare scenario for any person losing a member of their family in this way. I mean, how do you deal with something like that when filming? Do you have a teddy bear that you keep for between takes or something?
Yeah, that's so weird.
It's weird. Teddy bear?
Mine.
What?
That's classic transference. But it's every movie actually has it. It was weird on the set of The Source Code.
It is strange that you don't understand that a bear is actually mythological symbol.
Yeah.
For
it's life size, by the way. It's very huggable.
For masculinity and manliness. So when you had him
to put my shoulder on my head on his shoulder.
You brought the bear into this whole thing. I want to know. This is your fault. Whatever this bear thing is.
Your time's up. Sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She just got gold. That was gold.
Gold. Total 100%. Gold. So I mean, well, tell me about your characters, because they seem to have, in a weird way, a lot in common. There's a lot of anger kind of under the surface, I think, for both. But at the same time, they're clearly trying to keep control of that.
Yeah, absolutely. I think you've hit the nail on the head. I can certainly speak for my character in that he is trying to control his life. He is a survivalist. He doesn't have faith in anybody else to solve his problems or to protect his family. He's a recovering alcoholic, and life is a day-to-day struggle for him. So in this movie, you watch it unravel. I think the fascinating thing about this situation is how everyone reacts differently. And I think, and I'm going to say this to embarrass him, but for Jake, there was less on the page than what ended up in the film than of all the characters. I think you feel the emotion underneath, you feel the struggle, and always maintaining that veneer of the police officer, of the investigator, and who needs to keep the mind sharp and not let the emotions get in the way. But the issues of control are central to this movie, I think.
Ironically, I know that you mentioned the bear, but one of the tattoos I had was a bear,
right, yeah.
And a lot of it was because I felt like and this is going to sound very lofty and very actorly, unfortunately, which means hope. I mean, that's a euphemism for very narcissistic. But the search for these girls and the ferociousness that needed to sort of drive that search on both his side, but particularly the way I looked at it for my character on my side, was sort of bear-like in that way, you know, wandering through the woods and having to search for, you know, clues and things. And I really actually did connect with that idea. And yet at the same time, what was so interesting about this is that it is a dark world, but it was a fascinating world to explore. It was never ending. It was like this big, huge abyss of unknown. And I think that we encounter that every single day where we were working was emotionally, it was a big unknown. So scenes could become whatever you wanted them to become, really. Mm. They could go as far as you wanted them or not. And I felt that way as the character. He was just always searching through, trying to find answers in this great, vast unknown.
Mm. So would you both work with Denis again? I mean, I know you've done two in a row now. Are you?
I'd only work with Denis with you.
100% I'll work with him. And this man better. He's very unique. He is a very sensitive, he's a good man. He is a relatively happy man, and all his films dive into the depths of human experience, I think, probably because he's in a safe sort of place, but he's sensitive, he's a master storyteller, and he allows the audience to make up their own minds. And it's a rare, rare combination of things, as well as being able to make a classic thriller that keeps you on the edge of your seat. So, absolutely. But hopefully there'll be a few more laughs in the next one.
I've already made two with Denis.
Yeah, right.
It would be a third one in a row. Or not in a row.